Hello everyone. So with the Samsung Galaxy S4 announcement now well and truly over, we know what the next Samsung superphone is going to be. The Galaxy S4, an S and a 4 rather than with Roman numerals, is certainly a feature-packed piece of kit, although Samsung seems to be putting a lot more emphasis on software this time round, a trend that we saw with Galaxy Note 2, that whilst there are a couple of standout hardware features, it's really the software that seems to be getting a lot of the love from Samsung at the moment. So the Galaxy S4 will be launching with a 5-inch AMOLED 441 DPI display, which is full 1080p HD. Now, there's going to be two different CPUs, depending on where in the world you are. It'll either ship with the Exynos 5 octa-core at 1.6 GHz, or, and I think this is going to be if you're on LTE 4G, a 1.9 GHz quad-core Snapdragon. And at the moment, we believe that's going to be the 800. 130 grams is the weight, so it's shaving a little bit more weight to get off the current Galaxy S3. And it's a lot thinner as well. Shaved another couple of millimetres off there. A 13-megapixel camera on the back and a 2-megapixel front-facing camera. And beautifully, 100/50 megabit hexaband LTE, which is running on Category 3. And effectively, that means that worldwide, you're going to get the very fastest speed if your network does support it. They've certainly not skimped on the broadband chip here. 2 gig of DDR memory. So nice and fast, that brings it up to the same speed as the Galaxy Note 2 or the previous Galaxy S3 in certain territories. And they'll be shipping in 16, 32 or 64 gig of storage, expandable up to 64 gig or additional 64 gig through microSD. So potentially up to 128 gig. You've got a full range of Wi-Fi options, including N and the brand new AC standard for those who actually have that yet. MHL 2.0 has also been included, but not a lot of details on what's going to be new in there. Bluetooth 4.0 as well, an infrared blaster, and the actual casing is going to be made of the same polycarbonate by the looks of it as the Galaxy Note 2, and it'll be coming in black and white to begin with. For my mind, the Galaxy S4 has very similar aesthetics to the Note 2. You might almost mistake them, given the size of the screen on the S4 being 5 inches and the Note 2 being 5.5, they do look very, very similar. But that's not necessarily a bad thing. The Note 2, for my mind, is one of the better designed phones of the year. Samsung have really outdone themselves this time on the software features, including possibly at first, I think, a dual camera. So the idea with dual camera is if you're taking a video of your family and you're using the back camera, shooting away, you can include video footage from your front-facing camera, so the one pointing at your face, in the video, and you can position it where you like it. You can also insert still images as well. It's a really, really clever idea, and it makes great use of obviously all that processing power that's available in the S4, and you know, an extra spin on the old idea of being actually in your video, not just being a disembodied voice behind the camera, as it were. It looks great. How it will work in practice, we'll have to see, but it certainly looks like it'll be a really clever little feature. We're also getting, as it had been leaked many times over in the weeks running up to the announcement, eye tracking, smart scroll and smart pause. So basically they'll be using the front facing camera to track your eye movement. If you happen to look away from the screen whilst watching a video, it will pause the video and it will carry on playing again when you look back. And smart scroll, when it detects that you've look to the bottom of a page, it will scroll the page down for you. A very, very clever feature. And again, it's just extending what we already have really on the S3 and the Note 2 as far as the smart aspects were concerned. One of the features that really caught my attention, and I think this is going to be a real big one for a lot of people, is S-Translator. Essentially, Samsung have jumped ahead of Google on this one. Google have been working on this for a while, and Samsung seems to have beaten them to the punch. The idea is, if you're in a foreign country, or you're talking to someone here who obviously doesn't speak your language, you get out your S-Translator, you can either type in the phrase you would like to say, or you can speak the phrase, and S-Translator will then translate it into the other person's language for you, and then they can speak their reply. In practice, it looks very, very clever. How well it will work, we will see. But certainly they're launching with a very wide range of different languages available to begin with, including your standard European languages and Chinese. Very, very interesting. It's going to be very cool to see how that's going to work in practice. Adapt display. This is taking over from dynamic picture controls that were in the previous S3 and Note 2. The idea is a little bit like Sony's Bravia engine. It will detect the environment around it and immediately change the display to give you the best colour reproduction, effectively, depending on what you're doing. So if you're looking at a web page or looking at a picture or watching a video, it will adjust the dynamic screen colours, etc., to give you the most lifelike and best representation. Really cool. Carrying on really from where the camera comes in is a new system called Story Album. And this is basically a smart album. So if you're out and about and you're at an event or something like that, the camera, or should I say the phone, will tell you, hey, you're at an event. Would you like to create a smart album of this event? All of the pictures you take go into the smart album, and the whole album can be immediately shared with all of your friends. It's really, really cool, and it sort of feels a little bit like a Google Plus Events, with the way the pictures work on the event system there. Very, very clever, and nice to actually see, you know, this coming down as a key and core feature of the software on the phone rather than as an optional add-on. HomeSync introduces a new piece of hardware into Samsung's range, a 1 terabyte network-attached storage device with near-field communication. Essentially, you walk up to the HomeSync with your NFC-equipped smartphone, or any smartphone by the looks of it. You sync the device to the HomeSync, and all of your content will be dragged straight off it and placed onto the terabyte storage hard drive. At that point, the content can then be shared to any kind of device, Samsung smart TVs, or back to other smartphones. Really, really cool. Certainly just looks to be very similar to Microsoft's home storage system, which was released a few years ago. The name escapes me right now. Very similar, but more in tune with kind of modern technology and quick access. Next up is the S drive, or S voice drive. As you know, I've never been a big fan of S voice, but this certainly looks clever. It allows you to talk to your phone while you're driving and have the handset do everything for you. So if you get an email, it will read out the subject of the email and then say, would you like to reply, forward, do whatever. If you say reply, you speak your message, it will pop that into the email and then send it for you. All hands-free. Very cool, and it's going to be interesting to see how well that one works in practice. One of the other things that really caught my eye, and this is a great feature, is glove touch. They didn't brand it as glove touch, but effectively you can use the Galaxy S4 when you've got gloves on. How simple, how wonderful, brilliant, just what we were needing. So no more cold days and not being able to use your phone. Carry on with your gloves and it works fine. Another great feature for businesses and for those people with bring your own device policies is Samsung Knox. Now, this system was developed in combination with the US government, and it's designed to provide a completely secure layer for the device, which will allow it to talk to business corporate networks, and another layer, which is just for personal use. So you can effectively lock all your business stuff away at the end of the day, and the kids can't get in there and delete it all. Absolutely fantastic. Really interesting to see how well this one works in practice. It's a feature that I've been waiting for a very long time. Group Play is a great way to effectively turn all of your Samsung devices, smartphones, into a great big loudspeaker. So if you can share your music or your pictures or your video footage to up to 8 devices simultaneously, you have all those devices playing back. Really, really cool. The Air gesture feature is quite interesting. It's basically taking the Galaxy Note 2's S Pen, and instead of having to use the pen to actually touch the screen or hover over the screen, you can use your finger and it will give you the air gestures. So if you hover your finger over a video, it will start playing the video for you. Over a picture, and it will just slightly enlarge the picture. Really, really useful stuff. It's more about user experience, something like that, than being a killer feature. One of the things that we're always really interested in is, what's the battery life going to be? Well, it's got a 2600 milliamp battery. That's a slight increase over, I think, the S3's 2300. But obviously, we don't know what the drain is going to be like with all these new features and with the new display, which is slightly larger, and with the octa-core processor. There's a lot of really interesting technology going on in the processor, which should allow for better battery life. So it would be good to see, actually, when this launches at the end of April. So put that in your diaries, end of April for the Galaxy S4 launching worldwide. And we will see what this battery life is going to be like. I have a suspicion it's going to be pretty close to what we get from the S3 and the Note 2 today. But time will tell. So let me know in the comments if you're going to be picking up a Galaxy S4 on launch. We certainly will be, and we'll bring you a full review literally as soon as it lands. Enjoy, please subscribe, and keep tuned.